Hello and welcome back everyone. In this video we are going to talk about the different module pattern. So in JavaScript we have a different module pattern like common JS, ES6, AMD module pattern, UMD module pattern, and the native JS, which is known as the ES6 module pattern, right? So we have seen in ES6 that how we are creating the ES6 import and export, ES6 module import and export, named as a named export or default export. But before that, we were using the common JS module pattern in Node.js or in any generic programming, right? So we will talk one by one about all these different module patterns which we are using where. So AMD is the asynchronous module definition. So these modules are loaded asynchronously whenever we are requiring them. ES6 module pattern, whatever we are importing and exporting in the current world, in ES6 world, we are writing import x from this file, export this from that file. Those all are native JS, or these are ES6 modules. I will talk about that with example from the blog. Okay, so example, Node.js modules, all Node.js modules right now we are writing, those are common JS modules, because there we are using the syntax of require and module.exports. Okay, so pros and cons, you can take a look. So common JS modules are synchronous load whenever you are doing require FS module, so it is getting loaded. But UMD modules are, sorry, AMD modules are asynchronous. They are being loaded over the network, and the native ES6 modules are available as a synchronous and asynchronous fashion. Okay, so I already have a good blog on this, that how different module patterns are there. So default module pattern, which we write in JavaScript. So we already talked about this kind of a iffy block that you can write. The default mod, this is also called as a module pattern, is where inside a single object you are specifying everything. This is an anonymous function. This is the iffy block, right? You are defining your private variables and exposing them through the public functions. I mean, what this function is returning? This function is returning this JSON object. And then what you are doing? Migrates calculate.average or failing, these two methods you can call. So you can hide the main business logic inside this particular piece of code, and you can expose only two methods, average and failing. Then you can calculate. Okay, so this is called a module pattern, basic module pattern. And you already know the revealing module pattern we already talked about, where you are actually revealing these JSON pair of object from this function. So I can just directly calculate this, my grade calculate dot average or failing. This is the same example whatever we are having in the previous. Here we are just creating these two private variables and exposing these two private variables from the revealing pattern. Okay, those are actually kind of partially designed pattern, and we know, so whenever we write a reusable piece of code, we use to have some kind of a module pattern associated with that. Either you can use a prototype pattern, a singleton pattern, or module pattern, whatever you wanted to use. That is for the generic basic JavaScript code. But there are some modules which we are getting from the npmjs.com, a Node.js repository, or some we are loading as a asynchronous module, some modules we are loading as a AMD. Let's see the differences. Okay, so common JS is the modules whatever we are getting, whatever we are using currently with the help of require and module.export, all are common JS module. So we create a module and we export it like this, module.export, and then we require it something like this. So this kind of syntax we use for common JS modules. Okay, so it is avoiding the global namespace, making the dependency explicit, all these things it is taking care. And this is actually goal of all different module pattern, that we should avoid the collision of variables, collision of functions, and everything should be in a single file. Now talk about AMD. Common JS is very well good and it's loading the modules synchronously, but AMD is asynchronous module definition. It is loading these both the modules asynchronously, I mean over the time, not instantly. So this is how we use the AMD module, and required JS is there, which is helping us to provide a AMD kind of module definition. Like you can see, this code is running at asynchronously, because what it is doing, load this, and this is the callback function. Okay, then there is a UMD modules, the same as AMD modules. Here it is the subset of it. In the native JS, we are using the ES6 module pattern, where we are actually exporting something like this and then importing using like this. So this we talked in the ES6, right? So we are exporting the function from this file, and all the Angular, React, all these framework libraries are using this kind of import export. Here we are exporting three things: counter variable, function increment and decrement, and here we are importing them. Here I'm importing everything from this file. So I created alias, import everything as a counter from this file. So I can access them using counter.counter, counter.increment, all this. Okay, that's it about the module pattern in ES6.